we wait too long.
I typed in the chat. There it is. Hey, there's Batman. Look at that Batman. It's great.
Oh my God, we have a ton of subscribers already, Jack.
Great.
Saber Mao. Empel Sarikon Center.
On Kool-Aid Man for 15 months in a row.
I like the name.
Leftover Beefcake, 14 months in a row.
Go Fada.
God Fada.
Oh, I get it. God Fada 42 for 12 months in a row.
Fruit Pie the Magician.
Justin Horman for 19 months
Jesus
in a row.
Fucking Christ.
Jeebus Crisp.
Biff Meat Slab, 15 months in a row. Oh God, John Kilo 3.
John Kilo 3, who
just blew Justin Horman out of the water.
Sacrificed his own art stream tonight to come and mod for us 20 months in a row.
Smelter Wedging all of us, 16 months in a row.
Where are you, Pigeon 615?
Jedi Knight Steroid Jenkins.
It's Fish Butts. 12 months in a row.
Fish Butts.
Fish Butts, not it's Fish Butts. Butts. But that's adorable and I love it.
Madron.
And Nitro Inferno. Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
It's true. We really do. Okay, now give me one moment here. I'm going to update the stream now that we're playing Batman. We're going to play Batman, Arkham Knight. Batman, Arkham Knight. How about Arkham Knight? Okay. Arkham... Where are you? Batman Arkham Knight is not showing up. Oh, there it is. Never mind. I'm dumb. Everything's fine. Update. And updated. Great.
It'd be a cold day in hell when that's not showing up.
Okay. So we have a couple new things to play here. We have a Robin story, a flip of a coin, and a Catwoman story, Catwoman's Revenge.
Hey!
Okay, let's play this set after the events of Arkham Knight. Play as Catwoman as she exacts her revenge on the Riddler. That sounds like a great idea. Hold on, we should mess with the. We should see what Catwoman outfits we have.
How many race courses is the Riddler gonna make Catwoman play?
Oh, do I not have that downloaded? Oh, darn.
He's the Riddler, and he doesn't ask her riddles.
Not in this game.
He designs race courses. Because, you know, that makes sense.
Yeah, lots of sense.
Oh, good. I do have it active. The 1990s Catwoman skin. I like this a lot better.
Okay.
Look at that Catwoman. It's a great Catwoman.
It kind of looks like the female version of the Eddie Murphy jumpsuit in either Raw or the other one.
Delirious.
Delirious, yeah. I can never remember which one's purple and which one's red.
Okay, where am I? Catwoman's Revenge. Let's do this. I have to remember how to play Batman, which is going to be the hardest part, because I'm in Bloodborne mode, which is R1 and R2, but Batman is not that. Okay, so back to The Martian being an incredibly boring movie.
Yeah.
Have either of you seen, speaking of incredibly boring movies.
Okay.
Have either of you seen Jurassic World?
No.
Yeah.
What an incredibly boring movie.
It's like, you know, he's our generic action hero who's rescuing the woman again. And
No stakes whatsoever. The characters are incredibly bland. We spend no time with them whatsoever.
No, I was rooting for the dinosaurs the whole time.
Absolutely.
Can all eat these people, please?
None of the characters have, like, realistic motivation.
No.
There's this one, the boss this time, it's not Hammond anymore. The boss this time has this big spiel about how, like, money doesn't matter, and he was put in charge of the park because Hammond wanted the customers to have a good time. Spare no expense. And then the very next scene, he's talking about not killing the Indominus Rex because it costs so much money to make.
Yeah.
It makes no sense.
Yeah, it was just... Oh. And, like, the original one, I mean, the original one, it's like the saving grace was, like, all these majestic, awesome brontosauruses munching leaves and hanging out.
Yeah!
There was, like, no dinosaurs. I would say that there's no dinosaurs that are likable, but the human characters are so bland that you're rooting for the dinosaurs to eat them anyway, so... Yeah.
I've forgotten how to crouch.
But I am looking forward to playing the Lego version. Because, like, Lego dinosaurs running around, turning into blocks and stuff. Ah, so it's like, I'm a huge fan of the Lego games.
Shit. Uh-oh. And I've died.
You just got deaded.
Well, that happens. I've forgotten how to play Batman.
You're going to have to catch up on Ash versus the Evil Dead, Jack.
I know I need to. I spent the majority of my vacation time catching up on shit. And unfortunately, I did not get around to Ash versus the Evil Dead.
Okay.
But, like, I saw Jurassic World and was incredibly bored. And I saw, you know, The Martian and was incredibly bored. And and I died again.
Nope. You're doing great.
I feel like I'm doing
great.
You're
doing great. Is there a ceiling vent you can go through instead?
Maybe. I'll give that a try.
And don't forget magic vision, because everyone has that in these games, not just Batman.
I did like that. I did there was parts of Jurassic World that I really liked. They were wondering about, like, the petting zoo in Jurassic World. There's, like, that little petting zoo section where the kids are riding the baby Triceratops.
That's cute.
It's like, that's adorable.
And those ball car things that they were going through. I mean, those look like they would be a whole lot of fun in, like, one of those wildlife parks in Africa where they've got the lions and the elephants.
Oh, they had some really fun ideas. But
I also, it's a minor quibble, but did female secondary character have to run around in high heels the entire movie? Really?
I think she took them off.
You're not happy with any female portrayal in a movie. You're not. You're not. Mad Max, the movie that had all the MRA people, like, up in arms because there was a prominent female in the movie. You didn't like it. You didn't like it.
I wasn't crazy about the movie for a lot of reasons. It just wasn't a favorite of mine.
What?
I know I'm the only person on Earth who doesn't like it.
You didn't like Mad Max?
I didn't.
You are a crazy individual.
I know. I
movie of the year.
I
movie of the year.
Very well regarded by a ton of people. I'm just maybe not one of them.
You're an insane person.
I'm a strong person who is willing to disagree with the crowd.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I can't let him see me. That's what's going on here.
Someone in the chat is saying Road Warrior is better. That's a fine argument to make.
Sure, sure.
But Fury Road is still fucking great.
Road Warrior did not come out this year.
That's also true.
So that's why Fury Road wins Movie of the Year.
It was not excessively fond of Road Warrior either, to be honest.
Fury Road is more stylized. Road Warrior is more just kind of bleak and gritty. Oh, you're just putting, like, tracers on them or something?
No, I'm picking their pockets.
Oh, that's neat.
So, like, see this guy here? He's got that, like, glowing thing on him.
Uh-oh, Karen. I don't think the chat's fine if you're not liking Free Road. They're saying you're not the one for me anymore.
Oh, no.
You know, I'm going to have to agree with the chat there.
Oh, dear. Our relationship has weathered many disagreements.
But can we weather Fury Road?
I don't know. That's a big one. That's a big one. I had a friend once who broke up with his girlfriend because she didn't find Airplane funny.
She didn't find Airplane funny. Now, I do find Airplane funny. Surely you can't be serious. I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
Exactly. Oh,
Actually, last night, Rich and I watched for the umpth time Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Sure.
That is absolutely a favorite. That's my sense of humor right there.
Looney Tunes.
Looney Tunes, yes.
Do, 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 do.
Yeah, it may contain Disney characters, but it's definitely a Looney Tunes movie. In terms of its style, it's more like a Chuck Jones, Tex Avery kind of a movie.
Mm. Karen was thinking that Roger Rabbit doesn't get enough love, that it's kind of forgotten. And I don't know about that. Just because they haven't made a ton of sequels, I don't think that means that the public doesn't love the movie.
Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
Yeah.
That's a classic. That is a beloved classic.
But you would not agree, as me, that it's forgotten.
Yeah. Oh no, I don't think it's forgotten. I think it's a classic, and regarded as such.
I mean, I'm shocked they got Disney and Warner Brothers and basically everyone else to collaborate in the first place, let alone to get them to do it again for a sequel.
What?
A hard movie to make a sequel to, is what I'm saying. Because they got, you know, I mean, it's got to be extremely difficult, and there needs to be like teams of lawyers to get Mickey Mouse and Bugs Bunny in the same movie.
Yes.
Oh, I get it. I you know what? I heard that as if you were saying they also made a sequel.
Oh, no.
I'm trying to figure out how to get downstairs without being seen.
Well, there's ways you can distract people, right?
I don't know. It's been a while. It's been a while since I played, so I'm... Yep. Damn it. It's been a while since I played Batman.
You probably have to cause a distraction.
Oh, okay.
Or find a vent or something.
Right. I don't think Catwoman's a venter. I think she's a ceilinger.
Yep. Now, there was not a sequel to Roger Rabbit, but they talked about it.
Oh. Well, there you go.
I don't know if they've talked about it in a while. I don't think it's ever going to happen. There'll probably be an attempt at a reboot at some point, I'm sure, but...
You think?
It'd be a hard one to do for the aforementioned reasons, but...
That Hoskins is dead?
Well, no, they don't care about that. For the legal reasons of getting these characters together again. Working on a contract and who gets what. If Warner's was smart, they'd want to get Looney Tunes more exposure. They used to be on TV all the time.
They have a new show.
But the classic it's not the classic cartoons, though. There's a generations of kids that haven't seen the classic Bugs Bunny shorts or the Roadrunner and Coyote.
No, but Bugs Bunny has a new show.
Okay.
Wabbit is what it's called.
It's just called Wabbit.
Wabbit. It's a very strange name, but... She actually moves faster when she's crawling. Shit. Damn it. Yeah, Wabbit. I haven't seen it. I've only seen ads for it while watching other children's programming. But...
Jack, can you not do stealth takedowns?
No, you cannot do stealth takedowns. I tried doing a stealth takedown, and it did not give me the option to do one.
Okay.
I just need to steal these three things from people. This guy got one.
They're saying she makes no noise, whether she's crouched or not, that's her advantage.
Oh, well, there you go.
Why have they not rebooted the Goonies? I thought that would have been the most obvious. Eh. Goonies is alright.
Goonies is a good movie, but it's still overrated. It's good, but it's not...
It shouldn't be the classic that it's considered?
It's not one of the best movies of the 80s. There's a lot of competition.
Wait. Wait. So first we're messing with Fury Road, now we're messing with The Goonies?
Yeah. It's fine.
We're having words after this stream.
Okay.
We can have words now.
Goonies was great.
Goonies was all right, but I think a lot of the appeal is like the wish fulfillment fantasy of having an adventure when you're a little kid. So I think it was a movie that was great when I was a kid. You know, uh-huh. I wish I could go do this, but now as an adult, it's like,
I still think it has plenty of whimsy as an adult. But I mean, of course, it has that wish fulfillment. That was the point.
I just wonder if it has a lot else.
It was a movie for children.
Mm-hmm. And I saw it a few years ago as an adult, and it just wasn't the same.
Nah. What
the fuck? 80s was a great decade for movies, though. 80s was like the best decade for movies. Maybe I'm biased, but I'm going to say 80s was the best decade for movies.
Oh, she can go on the ceiling up here, too. Oh, I'm done.
Well, there was a dollar movie theater in the next town over from me, so I saw a lot of movies in the 80s.
We like looked at what else came out the same year Who Framed Roger Rabbit did, and like every one of those movies was great.
Yeah.
Quentin Tarantino says 80s was the worst. He doesn't like anything that wasn't made in the 70s for 50 bucks.
Tarantino has a very specific style.
Yeah.
That he enjoys. Do 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 do. Part of my catching up on stuff extravaganza, and the chat may or may not like this conversation that's about to happen, is I finally got around to watching One Punch Man.
Yeah.
Have you heard of this One Punch Man?
Karen has not.
Nope.
It is. It's one of those animes. that features a superhero who can defeat anyone with one punch. And so he's often very bored with his life because he's way too powerful.
So this is like a half-hour show?
Yeah, it's like a half-hour show. And at first I didn't want to really watch it because like it felt very egotistical to me of this just like being the creator's avatar, you know, like, oh, he's so powerful and he's just so bored. He's the greatest, but he's so bored. It's like, oh, I don't really care about that. And then the show got good for a little bit. There was this really nice middle zone where it just showed how like genuinely good of a character he was, even though he was way more powerful. He had concern for others, and then it just piddled out at the end like most animes do, and it's like, eh, I guess that's done. I guess nothing really changes, and everything's stupid. I really hated the ending of it. There was like two or three good episodes in there.
It was like Trigun. Rich and I really liked the first few episodes.
Trigun, yeah.
It just kind of goes downhill.
Well, and you know, Trigun is the same thing, right? Where it's like...
It gets full of itself.
Vash the Stampede is like the best shooter ever, and he's super powerful and strong, but at least, you know, he's like, oh, I don't want to kill anyone. That's his shtick, right?
Yeah.
And then, so it's like a really great premise, a couple good meaty episodes, and then just piddle.
Well, he gets so serious. He's this, you know, tortured soul alien. It's much more fun when he's this goofball who's running around screaming and eating donuts.
pretending to be incompetent.
Right. Yes.
Oh, I missed the silent takedown option.
So now it's just beat everybody up mode?
Now it's beat everybody up mode. Or at least that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm supposed to be doing this. I just want to fight people. Oh, shit.
Okay, run!
I'm
run, fool! Beat him up!
I forgot how to run. Catwoman doesn't run.
Hit X. Hold X.
Oh, hold X? Oh, God. Everything's terrible. Oh, geez. Too many.
Yeah.
Too many.
Yeah, I would say too many. If they see you.
I just went up. It's fine. It's fine. Ah! Whoa! Whoa, I'm up here now. Everything's fine.
You accidentally did a good thing.
I failed up. Fail up. Go, Catwoman. Go. Oh,
no. No.
So in any case, I was really excited about that One Punch Man because they had a couple, like, anime in general. And, you know, this is probably why I'm not super into it. I think I've watched more than most, but, or, you know, most people I know, but it's like it usually has like a really solid, interesting premise and then like a couple good episodes and then they maybe don't really think about the ending. I think maybe that's just a problem with TV in general is they don't really think about the ending.
What were my thoughts on The Last of Us?
Oh, that's right. You played The Last of Us.
Oh, God.
What was it everything you were hoping?
No, no. And more. Oh, no, and more. It was like The Order with a maybe a better story, but also not terribly exciting either story. Predictable. It's like The Order with a blender and predictable story, but at least the story that makes sense and not nonsense.
Uh-huh.
Whereas The Order only has bland shooting, the game portions of The Last of Us don't know necessarily what kind of game it is. Sometimes it's lackluster stealth, uh-huh. And then sometimes it's lackluster shooting.
Oh.
And that's what I have to say about it.
Okay. So it was exactly what you were expecting it to be.
I was playing it. And I'm like, okay, this character's gonna die here, and we're gonna get this reveal at this point, yep.
And then those exact things happened.
Maybe you could make it work if you paced it like a movie, but it's paced like a video game where there's lots of time between things that happen. Uh-huh. So it's just like a story with shitty pacing, is what you get.
Yes, which is the problem with story-driven video games, is they want to pace them like video games and not like movies. Okay. Well, I'm glad to know. I'm glad to know you were right. That makes me happy. That your assumptions about the game were correct.
Nowhere near as many, like, on-the-rail sections as The Order, where you're literally, there's just whole sections of the game where you can't move the camera and you're just looking for the next prompt.
Uh-huh.
It's less of that.
Okay.
And there's whole sections of The Order where you're just thinking, why is this even here? Why is this a thing?
Why right. am I here?
Why am I here?
The Order gameplay is so less inspired. Yeah. Look, it's bland either way you slice it. Order's just bland with less variety.
So Last of Us also featured bland gameplay.
I would say so, yes.
Then that's all that matters. And the story wasn't good enough to pull you through the gameplay.
The story was... It was a story. Their characters...
Because they were what?
There was Mr. My Daughter Died.
Uh-huh.
And then there was Surrogate Replacement Daughter.
Oh, okay.
You know... He's got to take care of her now. That's where they're going with that. And then there was his partner, Mrs. has to be bumped off at some point so the story can revolve around just the guy and the little girl.
Sure. Mr. Has to be bumped off at some point.
And then the story started with his daughter, Little Miss definitely gonna have to die for schmaltz.
Ah, schmaltz.
Some story elements which probably could have been fine if only they didn't try to make a game out of it.
I think we've talked about that, like, with other game makers, is, you know, the failed filmmakers. And they want so bad to make their story, but, you know, but they also know that games need to be longer than movies.
I hate the great system in Arkham Knight.
Uh-huh.
You just walk anywhere without being seen, is what this is.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm just waiting for him to come to me, and then I'll take him down. Oh, look, another guy by a grate. Oh, wait, there's a couple guys by a grate. I should probably wait. Can I get away with this? I can't believe I'm getting away with this.
Bodies keep appearing by these grates.
That's weird, right? Oh, shit. Probably gonna get caught here. Shit.
Just get out of there. Oh, you're fine. You're fine.
What are they gonna do here? They saw me go down the grate.
God, they ruined stealth in this game. They just ruined it.
That didn't do anything.
Well, if you're dumb enough to stay in that area, when you can, you know, run anywhere under the floor, you would have been in trouble. But fortunately, you could run anywhere.
Literally, I have the entire run of the floor. Oh, I can knock them out faster. How many guys are left? Does it even matter? Do I care about these guys? I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing. That's my only problem now, is I just... I think there's only two left.
Rich, Karen, and Jack, what is the most visually ugly film you have ever seen?
Visually ugly film?
I have to think about it. I don't know.
You know, that's an interesting question.
What makes for a visually ugly film?
That's what I was thinking.
Are we thinking about animated films or traditional films?
I'm assuming they mean traditional, but...
Visually ugly film. You know what? Kudos for asking an interesting question.
That I have no answer for. I'm sorry, because I like the question.
Yeah.
Do we mean like full of revolting images or full of disagreeable colors or poorly edited and setted like an Ed Wood movie?
Sure. Well, you know what I'm thinking of, which is a movie that has some like really interesting ideas but is like really ugly because they didn't have the budget for it. Did you guys ever see Equilibrium?
No. Mm-hmm.
Christian Bale, futuristic sci-fi fighter gun movie. It has some really interesting story ideas and like a weird combat, what do they call it? Gun kata.
Yeah.
They made up their own martial arts, which is fighting with guns like they were swords. It's crazy. But like just visually, because of the special effects and the low budget, looks very ugly. But an all right film.
Batman and Robin is pretty garish.
Garish is putting it lightly. Okay. All the guys are out now. Oh. Get out of my way, wall.
Because it's highly stylized, but it's a very ugly, highly stylized.
Yes.
And that's just atrocious to look at. Is there magic vision, Jack?
Oh, thank you.
Oh.
Like, maybe I was supposed to be looking for clues or something. Oh, wait.
Three.
Oh, I get it. So like, that's the warrior, so I need to hit the warrior third. So I need to look for a robot, a cabin, and a griffin.
Okay.
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 Great.
It's on that merry-go-round up there.
Yeah. Yeah. Can I like batarang up there?
Only Batman gets the batarang.
You know what I mean. You know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
Oh.
I'm just telling you why you can't do it.
He knows what you want to do. He's just telling you why. Wait, it
robot,
doesn't work.
Robot.
Oh, where?
Where do you one. See he's, huh? He's in the case.
Is
big
he?
Red robot. Turn right. Right. Straight?
Oh, okay. So robot's number one.
Sorry. Well, this is a Riddler thing.
This is an actual riddle, yeah.
Ish. Right. I don't know that it's a riddle.
It's
a puzzle. Yeah.
It's a puzzle.
What's in there?
It's not ish.
More robots.
More robots.
More robots.
Space.
This puzzle's kind of like a visual riddle or something.
Okay. Let's see what we got here.
So what do you want to talk about, Kurt? You're playing your bubble pop game.
You're playing a different game while we're playing a game?
This is exactly what she's doing. Because she does not give no fucks about the Batman. Talk to us. What you got? Fair.
About what? I'm playing Dodo Pop, which is a fun little Android game where you
just mindlessly click on colors.
No, this is not true. It's a puzzle game where you're trying to break open the right number of colored gumballs and stuff.
Oh, oh. Oh, wow.
And I've got it on the Amazon Underground thing, so I get, like, free power-ups and stuff that I don't have to pay real money for, because I'm not going to pay real money to play Dodo Pop.
I'm going to take that tablet away is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to take it away.
Robot.
I've been looking up now and then and watching Jack crawling around in his purple jumpsuit.
And saying nothing, which helps nobody.
I have very little to add. You guys are talking about games that I've never played.
What kind of movie or game would you like to talk about? Or a book? Or opera?
Have you guys been watching The Expanse?
What's that?
Sci-fi show. Haven't seen it.
Sci-fi show.
What's it about?
Speaking of visually ugly, it's based off of a book series, which apparently is very good, and it's about future Earth and Mars, it's future Earth and Mars. We've colonized Mars at this point. There's a whole Mars civilization. There's an Earth civilization, and there is an asteroid belt civilization that is mining resources for both Earth and Mars.
And they're living between Mars and Jupiter's orbit?
Exactly.
Okay.
And just kind of, you know, politics, Game of Thrones in space, very much that. And it's something that they don't have a lot of budget for special effects. They don't have a lot of budget for good actors. But the story is so good that you keep on watching. Even though, like, the acting's kind of bad, the special effects are kind of cheesy, it's like the story... It's really good.
And it's based on a novel?
Yeah. Or a series of books. It's based on one of those things where you read words.
Is it based on a series of books that's never going to be finished, thereby screwing the people making the show?
Well, the makers of the show knew what they were getting into. That George R. R. Martin, he doesn't give no fucks.
Do you know what? You don't have any idea what we're talking about with that, Ren, I'm assuming? Game of Thrones? Not that I've never watched
it. I know it's based on a series of books.
A Song of Fire and Ice.
They aren't... A series of books that aren't done.
Okay.
And the show has now caught up to the books.
Yeah.
That's a problem.
Like, what the fuck did they do?
Well, they could ask George R. R. Martin what he wants them to do, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Hasn't he given them like a synopsis? Isn't that what's happened? Or am I wrong about that?
I don't know. I've heard good things about Game of Thrones. I haven't watched it. I really, even though I've got Netflix and stuff, I really don't watch.
I don't think it's a lot Netflix. Of.
I watch, you know, some YouTube videos, and I mess around on Facebook, and I read books. I don't watch a lot of whole episodes of anything. At this point, the internet has ruined my attention span to the point where sitting there watching a half hour or something, I don't even really do that much.
Sure.
Although lately what I've been watching is, have you seen The Man in the High Castle?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Really like that.
The premise of that is, what if the Axis had won in the Second World War, and these people are living in a... And in America, the east coast of which is run by the Nazis, the west coast of which is run by the Japanese Empire under the descendants of Hirohito, I guess. And then there's a neutral zone in the like Rocky Mountain states area. Maybe even plain states like Illinois. I'm not entirely sure the exact boundaries of the neutral zone. Somewhere in there. Anything that they have happening in the neutral zones seems to be happening in, like, Colorado or something.
But, yes, very fun show.
Yeah.
Man in the High Castle.
And very grim show.
Yes.
It is a world where civil liberties are more or less non-existent, and the government kills people on a...
Sounds pleasant.
Very.
Sounds like something I want to avoid.
Well, what would you want to watch that makes you has all that feel good, happy feeling?
I don't know.
Oh,
Star Trek.
Star Trek.
I've never heard of Star Trek.
It's that thing with the Enterprise.
The Enterprise.
Captain Kirk.
Have you seen Transparent at all? Do you know anything about that?
Oh, that's Jeffrey Tambor, right?
I'm really, really bad with names.
The dad from Arrested Development.
I'm really, really bad with watching TV
It's with
shows.
Jeffrey Tambor.
Jeffrey, yes.
Maybe. I don't want to say yes because I'm not sure.
It's with Jeffrey Tambor.
But it's a man who has a very masculine face. I mean, I'm sure they picked him on purpose for that. And he's got an ex-wife and three children, I believe. And he comes out as transsexual.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just... Mostly about him, but it's also about his family and his children's lives as they intersect with this coming out. But also, they've got their own issues, and it's about the whole family and every different person's different issues.
I've not seen it. I have heard good things.
It's really good.
And Jeffrey Tambor is great.
Yeah, it's like an Amazon Prime exclusive, I think.
Mm-hmm.
But I think you can pay for episodes individually if you don't have Amazon Prime. I know, the problem is there's so much stuff to watch. So much content, yeah. And not just stuff to watch, but games to play and internet to surf. I mean, I was talking to Rich. I was like, when I was a kid, you had, in the wintertime, you know, my parents didn't really want me out after dark. You know, you go to school. I mean, when I was a kid, you know.
Yeah.
And it's like you get out of school and the sun sets an hour later in Illinois.
Yeah.
And northern Illinois, and just as bad up here. And so, I mean, your options... What do you do? You can either draw, you know. I mean, I didn't have any siblings in the house with me, so you can either, like, draw or, you know, do something crafty, or you can watch TV. We didn't have any video games. I didn't have any video games. Some people had video games, so it was like, you know.
The cool kids had video games.
Yeah, the cool kids had video games, but it's like either watch TV or you read a book or you, like, make something. Those were the options, and now there's, like, options up the wazoo.
Oh, yeah, it's great.
And yet we end up watching shit like Monumental Mysteries together.
Monumental Mysteries is great because it's so eclectic. It's just...
it's a show on the Travel Channel where they just...
Yeah.
They just talk about shit that happened a while ago.
No, like they'll show like a while ago. This giant pyramid, and they're like, okay, well, here's a story about the pyramid. And it's like the pyramid's dedicated to these guys who funded the Pacific after it kind of went under. They tried to pick up funding for the Pacific leg of the Transcontinental Railroad, and they screwed their workers out of everything and got kicked out of Congress and ran off and disappeared. But there's this pyramid that's dedicated to them.
And basically, it's on the Travel Channel, so they have to find a way to tie it to travel, and they just want to talk about whatever.
Yeah.
And they built a statue about it.
And you can travel here to see the statue.
Well, I mean, mostly it's interesting buildings that have strange backstories. Like, sure. There's one where there's this castle called the Mystery Castle. I forget exactly where it is, but this girl...
It's a mystery.
It's a mystery.
You just don't know where it is.
And this girl...
Static
there was a family, and the father, you know, was very close with the family, and then he goes and he disappears. Uh-huh. And I guess after the fact, they find out that he was dying of tuberculosis, and he didn't want to give it to his family. Oh. But he was always talking to his, reading princess stories and building little fake castles with his daughter as she was growing up. Mm-hmm. So he went off, you know, apparently didn't die right away of tuberculosis, and he went off, and out of garbage and salvage and all kinds of weird stuff, he built her a castle.
Oh.
And then, you know, after he died, she found out about this. I guess she's still living there or something.
In the garbage castle?
Well, yeah. But, it, I mean, you know, not necessarily made out of, like, you know, rotting macaroni.
Sure.
Like, salvage parts.
Oh, okay.
Like,
no,
you know.
No game audio, just an occasional burst of static.
From which?
Well, I mean, when I hit the robots, it kind of sounds like static.
That's true. It could just be that the audio from your explosion noises on the TV is not coming through very well.
Sounds like our audio's bad. I'm hearing a lot of complaints.
Oh, okay.
Turn the gain down on your mics, audio issues. What do you want to do? Static.
Static?
Yeah. Can we be getting interference from something?
No.
It's going on right now. Cell phone by my speaker's static. Do you think my tablet sitting here could be a factor?
Oh, if you have it, if you are like hooked up to the internet, perhaps.
I am.
Perhaps.
Let me try.
Unlikely. I mean, I guess usually that's the only thing that's unusual in this setup is usually we don't have. No, sometimes I have like my iPad. You wouldn't happen to have like cell service on it, would you?
No, my cell phone is over there.
Hmm. Where's your cell phone?
It's in my purse. It's over there.
Under the mic thing? Why don't you move your purse?
Let me All right, I'm going to take my purse containing my cell phone and my tablet and put them in another room.
Okay, just in case.
Seems to have stopped right now.
Sure it has.
Or maybe it's, you know, my electric personality because I left the room with them.
Ooh. All right.
Okay. Microphone back near my head somewhat. Okay.
Ah.
Karen's wearing a wire.
Karen's secretly recording us recording.
Yeah.
This live.
It's a bootleg copy in case I don't want to stream it off the internet later.
Karen's doing a black market stream of our stream.
She's doing a cam version of the stream. She's filming the TV.
Yeah. Shaky filming.
Still no game audio, though.
The game audio's pretty quiet.
You really need to hear punch, punch, kick, punch? I mean, really? Is that a...
Yeah, it's just like clanging metal. The game doesn't really have any music or anything interesting. It's just the sound of, Catwoman kicking metal monster people.
It doesn't. Like, is that weird? Is that... I'm trying to remember the rest of Arkham Knight or Arkham Asylum. Did the rest of the game have...
Yeah, don't these things usually have, like, dramatic audio?
You would assume.
It's just some DLC they threw together. For $50!
Yep, this is part of the season pass.
But yeah, audio-wise, you're not really missing much. But if you want the basic effect, just take a microphone.
Jack, you keep running into the electric.
Put it in your silverware drawer, and then just start moving and jiggling your silverware, and you'll get about the right noise.
I think I need to use my whip more.
After kicking all of these robots, Catwoman's feet should be mush by now.
Yes. What are her shoes made of?
Something that lets her grab onto grates, obviously. Does she have high heels?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She always does.
Does the other outfit have high heels?
Catwoman always has high heels. I've never seen her without high heels.
I'm almost certain in this modern day and age, there's probably been versions of Catwoman without high heels. The woman has had too many outfits at this point.
I would agree with Karen that high heels are Catwoman's staple. I'm sure there exist outfits without high heels, but
I'm gonna say the only thing that's a staple are ears. Then again, the Dark Knight.
Oh. Does that even count?
I would bet however many costumes she's got, upwards of 95% of them feature high heels.
Oh yeah.
And ears. Not just high heels or ears. High heels and ears.
Oh, crap.
I like this costume. It's
This is the far superior costume. I really dislike her like more realistic costume that
the all black ones are
sucking. Yeah, with the red eye things, the red goggles.
You getting tired? Do you want me to take over?
Yeah, I do.
I exactly want you to take over because I'm sucking.
Ugh. This guy needs to wash his shirt once in a while.
No, that's his shtick. He's a what do you call him? One of those things.
A jerk.
He's one of those things.
Grungy jerk guy.
He's one of those things. Hey, Rich.
Yeah.
Did you hear about the Platinum Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game?
No.
Are these Platinum Turtles?
They're no.
Platinum's a company that makes games.
Okay.
Platinum is a company that makes very fun brawlers. And they have not officially announced it yet, but there keeps being leaks. Apparently, Xbox just leaked all of the achievements for the game that has not been officially announced yet.
What platforms?
Don't know. Unknown. Xbox for sure.
I'm the only one that likes that last TMNT game they made that everyone else hates.
Yeah.
Out of the Shadows.
Yeah, yeah. The art looks, there was some leaked art a while ago, and that looks interesting.
Yeah, what style are they going with? Cartoon?
Comic book looks.
Oh, like the classic black and white?
Not the classic black and white, but that's what...
Like a cell shading kind of a thing?
It looks like classic black and white, but colored in. You know.
Oh,
like
I'm down with that. Okay, here's the thing with me. If it looked like the 80s cartoon,
yeah,
I would have been horribly disappointed. That would have ruined my night.
Yeah.
But if they're going with Eastman and Laird style, fuck yeah.
Yeah, it looks good. It actually looks surprisingly a lot like... Did you have you read at all Batman and TMNT? Freddie Williams?
Oh, Freddie Williams?
Freddie Williams.
I haven't read it because I haven't been in a comic book store in years, but it looks very good.
It is, by the way. Issue number one is really fun. It's a very fun read. And I really like how he draws the turtles. And the Platinum game looks a lot like his style, which is what I'm excited about.
Did relocating that stuff help the static at all?
Don't know. What are they saying?
Well, I'm asking them, and, you know...
Oh, it's really hard to stay... There's got to be a key to not getting...
And if they're saying that it didn't, then I'm going to look up that game so you guys can see what the graphics look like. But if that was the fix to the static, then I'm going to leave my electronics in the other room. Haven't heard any since.
Yeah, if
heard
they
no
go...
static since, so that probably is the problem.
If they go Eastman and Laird style, day one purchase for me.
Thank you, guys. And girls.
Yeah, they say no more static.
Cool.
Great. So, yeah.
So then it was probably my phone or my tablet. One of them.
It was your tablet.
So there's got to be more to this. Why does the electric keep showing up?
It's when they go on those green glowy squares.
I mean, how do I keep the green glowy squares from coming about?
Oh, I have no idea.
18 inches from the mic. Yeah, it was definitely less than 18 inches from the mic.
Is it a matter of beating these guys fast enough?
I just have no idea. That's what I did on the last level. Is I just kept punching them, and that seemed to work.
Speakers, mic, everything was within a few feet of each other.
Yes, we are using XLR cables. We're using XLR into my Zoom H6. We haven't talked about that yet because Rich and I universally don't give a fuck about virtual reality. But Rich, did you see that they've announced the Oculus pricing?
No.
$600.
Oh, Lordy.
Yeah.
I don't care about anything that's $600.
And I wouldn't care if they said it was $100 because I don't care about virtual reality.
No, I think it's a neat concept. I'd like to try it.
Yeah.
And if I liked it, if it was $600, I'd wait a few years and see if I could pick it up refurbished for like $100.
Yeah.
I'm a patient person. There are things that are on my shopping list to get when they go down.
Like sure.
I want a Nintendo 3DS XL.
Are we not hearing tips? Somebody says we ignored their tip. Jack, did you check tips?
Last tip I have is the one that called me AIDS Moby.
Okay.
That's the last one I have. I don't know if it's different on yours. But
could that be set up weird with the 32-bit version of OBS we had to use to stream the Elgato?
No, because we heard that one.
Moby looks like AIDS Moby. I mean, you're.
I was gonna say
more body fat than Moby does.
I'm bigger than Moby.
Yeah.
Hold on, I've restarted our.
They started calling Jack that though, right after Jack lost a ton of weight, so he just saw it as a compliment.
Oh, okay.
Exactly. Well, and you know, those first couple of Best of the Worst, I was still wearing like shirts that were a little too big for me, and so like I guess I looked skinnier. Oh, you know what? You guys are right. We have been missing tips, and I'm very sorry about that. Joe Kitty 001 says, "Hey there, guys. Here's some money to fix that crackly mic. Get on it. Thanks for the stream. Sorry about that."
Sounds like the problem from what people were saying and based on what was happening was that I was holding a tablet in my mouth, probably about
your
six
mouth.
No, in my lap.
Excuse me.
My phone's up. No. Ah, wrong word. But I was holding a tablet about 6 inches from the microphone, and that was probably the problem.
Just this guy, you know, says, "Hey, Jack, Rich, Karen, welcome back."
Aww.
Caught a bit of Rich and Karen the other day. Always fun. Anyways, don't let me interrupt you too much. Please go back to talking about TV shows I might like. Thank you, just this guy, you know. And Tiberius Kirk says, 2016 is Star Trek's 50th anniversary.
Wow.
And to celebrate tomorrow on the holodeck, I've set up Space Seed, Wrath of Khan, Q-Who, and Best of Both
Wrath
Worlds.
Wrath of Khan. That's something not to be missed.
Oh, that's great, Tiberius. 50th anniversary of Star Trek.
That's crazy.
So yeah,
this is a crazy fight. That's what this is.
You just can't punch those guys. You got to cartwheel around them, wait for them to stop glowing.
Do you ever think that there will be a well-received, popular, universally loved TV reboot again?
Of Star Trek?
Yes.
Anything's possible.
I mean, there have been some TV reboots, but only the original and next gen have been universally beloved and well-received.
Yes. Agreed. Anything's possible. And I say even this is probable. A good Star Trek show. It all depends on who picks it up.
Yeah.
If it's something like...
Fuck!
Oh, Rich, that was the closest one yet. If it's something like Sci-Fi Channel, maybe. If they're okay with shorter runs, you know, like a 12-episode season, which is very popular nowadays, then they can dedicate a decent amount of budget. Netflix could pick it up. Netflix does great work.
Amazon has buckets of venture capital being thrown on
exactly.
them.
Exactly. It all depends on what if they get picked up by too big of a network, they're going to get screwed over. Because then there's going to be too many people trying to dip their fingers in the cookie jar.
Yeah.
You find some people who really like Trek and you know, give them a little bit of freedom. It's it's possible and probable, but it's always a crapshoot.
For Netflix, I mean, that would be a great
it's gonna be on
a great enticement for people to subscribe to Netflix.
There's gonna be another show. It's gonna be on CBS's streaming site, though. It's not gonna be on TV.
What?
The new Trek show they're gonna make.
It's gonna be on CBS streaming?
Yeah.
What the fuck is CBS streaming?
I don't fucking know, but it's what it's going to be on.
I don't care if it's on TV or not. That doesn't matter to me. I've got internet access.
Right, right.
I mean, I know it matters to some people, but personally, I'm not worried about that. What I'm worried, and I'm not even worried about, you know, I'm willing to spend a nominal fee to watch it commercial free. What I'm not willing to do is to watch it. I don't know, even with Star Trek, if I would be willing to watch it where every 5 minutes is interrupted by 5 minutes of the same three commercials, which is how the internet tends to work. And that's exasperating. It's like, commercials are bad enough, but when you see the same commercial over and over again.
That's what they do on, I don't know if you have Hulu at all.
Doomed.
Do Hulu?
Do you watch Hulu?
A little bit, not too much.
That's what they do on Hulu. Even if you're a subscriber, you pay the monthly fee, you get the same.
This one's doomed.
You get commercials, and it's the same three commercials for every single episode, and it is annoying as shit. And usually they're commercials for Hulu.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, CBS All Access is a $6 a month online only.
Yep.
But what about commercials?
For $6 a month, you'll probably get commercials.
If I'm spending $6 a month for one channel, I better not get commercials.
Oh, you'll get commercials. No commercials, probably, what, 15 a month, right?
Oh, God.
Gobbledygook.
Netflix
that's right.
Doesn't have any commercials, and it's not 15.
Rich, today is Gobbledygook's birthday.
Happy birthday, Gobbledygook.
Gobbledygook sent us a tip to say, my lazy college kids want Oculus to watch TV while they're lying down. It's also my birthday, and I wish for a TMNT turn-based RPG where I make my own heroes. And DC Online for the PS4 is for you fucks.
Why would you want a turn-based TMNT where you make your own heroes?
Wouldn't you want to
play as the Turtles?
It could be fun to make your own mutant.
No, you could. Then you're not playing a Turtles game. You're playing something else.
As long as it's an option and that there are presets so you can play, adding things is never a bad thing as long as you, you know, have preset options for
people
who don't want to
do that. You have your turtle game, right? And you go through the turtle game once and then you can make your own mutant.
No interest. No interest at all.
Rich, you are a jaded old man.
That's like some kind of like DC massively multiplayer thing where you couldn't play as Batman. that just sounds terrible.
That's the DC Online that he's talking about.
What? Oh, really?
I want to get back to the Oculus lying down thing. You know, there's a technology that you can buy for probably about $10,
okay.
maybe a little bit less that you can get that helps you watch TV laying down.
What's
it's
that?
Called a pillow.
It's got. Don't they already have that? Like, isn't it called, like, the Google Cardboard?
Yeah.
We could market the Oculus Nap.
Ooh. Okay.
It'll be like a pillow. It'll only be $475.
No, you'll have the Oculus Woo Machine. You'll close your eyes, and it'll project different colors on your eyelids, and you'll either tell people that it improves their mystical waves or that it resets their melatonin or something, but that it's medicinal.
We'll
so
put
you can
crystals
charge extra.
In it.
You just went somewhere entirely different with that. You took that bit, you just went off to space.
No, I like it. So we'll get one of those like massage chair pillows, like the pillows that has the face cut out of it, right? So you can lie down on your stomach, and then we'll mount a screen.
Yeah.
With an HDMI in, and it'll be the Oculus Nap.
Yeah.
And it'll be great, Rich. And we'll sell it for $249.99.
Oh, I was thinking $1,999.99.
All
like
that.
The gas stations do.
We'll sell it for slightly cheaper than the regular Oculus.
Oh, yeah. No, you should sell it for more because you're going to pretend that it's medicinal.
Oh, that's right. We're putting crystals in it. We're putting crystals in it, and you rub oil on the crystals to center your chi.
Yeah, and there'll be
and
some
that makes the shows funnier.
And there'll be some big scandal when we try to get Medicare to cover it.
What? You just use this, and suddenly Jim Belushi's funny.
And suddenly Dane Cook is funny. I think in order for Dane Cook to be funny, you have to be from Boston. It's a requirement.
Like I defend Dane Cook.
Why?
I think his enthusiasm makes a lot of his jokes, which aren't necessarily funny, work. I think he has a great enthusiasm.
Laugh, for God's sake.
He commits.
Please.
I need you to laugh.
He commits. I think there's some funny Dane Cook. Someone tries to refund our Oculus nap with integrated comedy crystals, saying, listen, I watched 2.5 Men and I didn't laugh. And we say, oh, no, that's part of the warranty. No, 2.5 Men is not covered under our comedy warranty.
Yeah, it's in the small print.
I officially hate this section. Is Prereq going to stream XCOM 2 next month? When it comes? I'm going to stream the fuck out of XCOM 2.
Yeah, no, Rich will... We will exclusively stream XCOM 2 for as long as Rich...
For the foreseeable future.
As long as Rich wants to, because that's all Rich is going to want to play. And if I say, hey, maybe we should do something else, Rich is going to say, fuck you, yeah, and elbow me in the face. And then we're going to play more XCOM 2.
Oh, fuck this fight.
I'm getting tired of looking at these green things.
So am I.
I like to see it. I'm not saying that like Dane Cook is the best or even like great stand-up, but you know he's got a couple funny bits and he has a really good performance. He's committed.
He's saying he enjoys him, whereas I not so much.
Yeah. I'm not saying I would ever like buy anything of his or listen to him for long periods, but I've heard stories of his that I've found amusing.
See, whenever I've watched it, it seemed like the audience's main attraction was that he was from Boston. Hi, I'm not from New York! Yay!
Oh, I didn't get that.
You know?
I didn't
probably
get that.
Probably a show he did in Boston.
Oh, sure.
I saw him once. Yeah. We're at your parents' house, and your father was watching him on the cable. And I was
did
watching
Dad
it.
Find him funny?
I don't. He doesn't. He just sits there and watches TV. He doesn't care what's on.
That's true. I think he just kind of spaces out or falls asleep or maybe a little both.
He's the kind of person you got to put a mirror under his mouth every now and then. Just
yeah.
Sure.
Dad is almost terminally mellow.
And I was watching. I'm like, is this supposed to be funny?
Nah, some of it I think is funny.
I hate this fight, Jack.
You should hate this fight. It's terrible and tedious. Just rewatch the Sharkspear says just rewatch the Pokemon stream. Rich was on fucking point that night. Speaking of Rich, did you see the upcoming Rick and Morty Pokemon clone?
No.
You get to train your Mortys. You get to build up your Mortys to fight other Mortys. I know you are a fan of the Rick and Mortys and a huge Pokemon fan.
That's
so
the one with that weird professor guy and.
And the kid?
Yeah. Which one's Rick and which one's Morty?
Rick is the older one, okay. And Morty is the kid. Rick is the scientist.
Well, I can't use any moves because she'll just, without my being able to control it, she'll jump into the electric.
Yep.
This sucks.
Jack.
Oh, I did a counter, and she countered into the electric and died. Isn't that fun?
I'm sorry.
Does this mean we have to watch this again?
Yep.
Oh, do I? Oh, is that Riddler? The question marks?
Yep.
It's like the worst Riddler costume ever.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah.
I've kind of gotten used to the Gotham version of the Riddler.
Jump into the electric? I don't think you can do that. Yeah, this is pretty lame DLC. So far, the Catwoman DLC has lived up to the lame DLC that we have all grown to hate.
Is there some kind of puzzle thing I'm missing?
I think you're just supposed to fight harder, stronger.
Like you're not supposed to jump on a particular block 6 times or...
You just
something Riddlerish.
You just can't fight the ones that are glowing green.
Well, you can't fight because I did the move and she jumped into the electric.
Yeah.
Because she auto targets some guy.
Right.
And goes into the electric. Mm.
Oh, you know what? We haven't streamed N++ yet. I really enjoyed N+. Did you guys ever play N+?
I don't know. I have any idea what that is.
Really great platformer. Like, very minimalistic. Like, you play as, like, a ninja. It's just a platformer. It's amazing.
So N for ninja?
N for ninja. And it's just called N+. And they recently came out with a sequel, N++. That's a game that I would really enjoy. I really liked N+.
That's got to be confusing. You go to the store and you're like, oh, yeah, we've got N+. You've got N++? Oh, yeah, here it is. No, that's N+. I want N++.
Do you have N+ plus the DLC?
Yeah.
But that's all right. No one goes to stores anymore. Mm. The only winning move is not to play this DLC. You are right, Jedi Knight's Droid Jenkins.
Oh, she went into the electric again.
If you win this room, do you get to go somewhere else?
Yes. Or there's another level of this.
Please, not another level of this.
We're not quite freewheeling Pope. We're not quite ready to move on to another game yet. We want to see if we can beat this.
And Rich is pretty good at this kind of stuff, yeah. So we might.
Is there a puzzle element we're missing?
It's possible.
Because we're not really listening to this game.
We're not really paying attention or listening, right. So it is quite possible. Sean sent us a tip to say, I predict a lot of news stories about the scourge of motion sickness with the newfangled video game thing on local news station after the Oculus is released. Yes.
That's probably a good call.
Yes, it will be a real thing.
And they'll make it sound like it's a medical malady that's going to kill young people.
Yes. Is your child at risk? This newfangled video game technology is ruining lives.
Can this make your child go blind?
Watch at 10.
Oh, fuck that. I hate this so much.
No, and like I said, I don't think that it's there yet. There's no force feedback. There's no tactile feedback. It's just a headset. I don't think playing a game with a controller and that headset is going to make that big of a difference.
No, I mean, you could have force feedback, dual analog, whatever, you know.
Oh, Jack,
so you have vibration in your hands, but you wouldn't really have much for the rest of your body.
Right, and so it's just like, I don't think that the gaming experience that people are expecting with virtual reality is going to be there yet. And, you know, not saying it won't be one day. I'm just being a grumpy old man because I just don't care about VR. Oh, someone has a good... try Detective Vision.
Kind of sounds like it would be like Omnimax.
She doesn't have it?
Yeah, it's up on the...
Is it? I thought it was one of the. Maybe that was one of the older Arkham games.
Omnimax is something that they have. I mean, they have like flat versions, sort of too. But like at some of the museums, they've got like a dome shaped viewing screen, and you sit there and it kind of surrounds you, and then they'll show like nature stuff, like the underwater stuff and whatnot. It feels like you're moving, and I think that's probably about what this would be with the
possibly, but your chair isn't moving. Like
no, but your eyes, if your eyes tell you you're moving, you think you're moving. Mm. I was in a fun house, and it was a tube, and they projected around the tube these colored lights that were moving.
Uh-huh.
And you're like, if you don't close your eyes, you have to like hold on to the handrails because your body says this room is tilting, and you can't walk straight.
Sure, that's fun.
So I mean, your body does believe your eyes on that stuff. Mm. But as far as the other senses, I mean, so you could get the sense of motion and vertigo and stuff like that out of one of those, but. Yeah, it can't do hot or cold. Or...
Right. Like, you give me some newfangled controls that maybe give me some feedback, then maybe I'm into it. But like I said, I don't like the idea of strapping something to my face. I don't like 3D movies. I don't like anything that requires... Because I have to live with glasses anyway. I know it's uncomfortable to strap things to your face. I don't want to do that more.
In 3D movies, like they're fun for a few minutes, but they always give me a headache after a while. Mm-hmm.
No, and I've heard, like, there is a huge problem with motion sickness and the Oculus with all of the, like, developer versions that have been out and all of the testimonials, there is a big problem with motion sickness.
I don't doubt it. I have problems with motion sickness with some not this game, but some of these sorts of 3D games.
Absolutely.
Not with actual, you know, getting sick, but with starting to feel not great.
Oh yeah, no, I have the same problem with some first person games. If the frame rate isn't right, if something's a little bit off, I feel the exact same way. And yeah, I think it could be really fun with horror. Tyrannosaurus Rex says it could be really good with horror, and it could be.
Well, that's a genre I love.
Well, and it, you know, that's not a huge genre. Is this going to be? And you know, wait and see what games come out for it. That's always the thing, right? Don't buy the system. Yeah. Buy the games.
Do you remember all the when Columbine happened and everybody was blaming Doom? They're going to be doing this with that. Oh, this is so realistic. These people are training to be killers.
Again. They're training to be killers
even though of that generation. Please find me a young man who didn't play Doom.
I didn't play Doom.
No?
No.
And out of all of them, you were the serial killer.
How did you know? Because of the bodies.
I was like, people play Doom, and they did something, and a lot of people played Doom and didn't.
Did it?
Congratulations,
Rich.
Rich
played Doom, and look how good he turned out.
A schmuck who wants to die. Please kill me.
Oh my so you won?
That's the question, Freewheeling Pope, is what will be the killer app for a virtual reality headset? What'll be the selling game, the selling app? And I don't know.
I'll go to the bargain bin and play the coral reef game where you just float around and look at the fish.
It'll be a porn game.
It'll be porn. That's exactly what it'll be.
Well, you know, I mean, I'm sure you could. Now, the major manufacturers aren't going to release the kind of peripherals that I'm thinking of, but you know, I'm sure it wouldn't be too hard to have an appliance with a USB cord.
People are saying lightsaber game. I want to say something.
Oh
here.
Yeah,
lightsaber
Wait,
game.
No, for a very good reason.
Okay.
Sword fights, right?
Yeah.
What happens when you hit it? What happens when you hit another sword in a sword fight?
You stop.
You stop.
Yes.
What happens when you're swinging the sword and there's nothing to hit? you're going to have to, like, pretend to stop?
Exactly.
Well, no, it's going to be terrible.
They could at least have, like, vibration feedback when you're supposedly hit.
Oh, it's not the same. It's not the same. We got a tip from most likely a bot. Just wanted to say thank Jack and Rich for the work of putting the stream together. Special thanks to Rich and Karen for the solo streams over the Christmas break.
Aww.
Yes. Thank you so much for streaming while I was out. I know everyone appreciated it. And I heard you had a lot of fun and a lot of explosions.
We did. And it was kind of a spur of the moment thing because Rich had family up and we were watching the Star Trek movie, and which we're still not going to spoiler. But
the Star Wars movie?
We're about at spoiler, who cares, territory with that.
Okay, well, you told me not to spoil it.
Last night. It's been a few days.
Okay.
We'd give a warning. We can talk about it later in the stream.
Okay.
Star Wars. I still think probably some people have not had a chance to see it yet, so we'll give a warning before we go into full Star Wars crazy talk. I do actually want to talk about Star Wars as I finally am catching up with the Max Landis craziness.
Mm-hmm.
And a couple things I want to mention about that. But anyway.
So Rich's guests left, other than me. His family left, and we didn't know exactly when they would be there, which showing we would see. Oh.
Oh. That was it?
That was it.
And
wait,
Rich is
what happened
like,
at the end there?
Rich is like,
I stole his money with the computer.
That was it?
That was it. You don't fight the Riddler.
God damn, this DLC sucks. Every single bit of this DLC sucks.
$50.
They're charging $50 for this.
For
all of these extra things.
Oh.
All of them together, plus race courses. More race courses.
Wow.
Yeah.
So Rich is like, how do you feel about doing a stream today? And I'm like, okay. And he's like, well, let's go. And I'm like, huh? And he's like, we're supposed to start like 10 minutes ago or something. And I'm like,
here's the deal.
Ugh, okay.
Last Sunday, that was kind of like family day for me. It was my Christmas. Dad, it was my dad and sister, it was Karen. Yeah. We went to see Star Wars. And I didn't know what time my dad and sister were going to want to go home. If they wanted to stay till 10, I wasn't going to kick them out saying I had to stream. And it just so happens they left at 8 o'clock. And I'm like, if we leave now, we could do a stream on time.
Well, first she asked me, like, how do you feel about doing a stream? And I'm like, okay, well, let me do this and this and this. He's like, Ken, there's no time. Okay. Well, you're welcome, the real Vian. And thanks for saying I'm awesome. Mm-hmm. Or something. Festivus for the Evans family.
Aw. Aw, yep. Did you air your grievances?
Which grievances? What?
Festivus.
Early and often,
Did you have your feats of strength?
He snores. Is that a...
That's a feat of strength.
That's a feat of strength.
Yeah.
All right. Do we want to throw up the spoiler warning?